profession where you sit and concentrate mentally most of the time, it is nice to be able to actually have a physical outlet. But that's a very obvious counterbalance, if you like, for what we do to earn our living.
Good timpani playing doesn't rely on physical stamina of any kind. I want to scoop, almost literally, I wish to scoop the sound right out of the bottom of the instrument and let it come out. It's there. You allow the arm to drop with its own body weight. You can produce volumes that are quite horrendous with very, very little physical effort. You have no one to hide behind or to blend in with. You're on your own. And all of a sudden you feel very naked. The whole concert hall is listening to me. They're not. But that's something that's very difficult to rid yourself of.
Yes, I've got a problem. You know our shelter that we're doing next week? We had a change of conductor at the last minute because Andre Previn wasn't able to appear. I was wondering, I think we ought to do some extra advertising just to let people know that there's been a change. At the same time, we must mention Maurice Murphy, who's playing the trumpet, and he's our principal. Trumpet, so I think we ought to give him a good mention as well.
I'm going to be playing the Haydn up in Glasgow. I don't get nervous anymore now. Well, most of the time I look forward to doing it, actually. Quite enjoy it now.
You might forget.
Oh, there's always a chance you might forget, but I mean, if you worry about it, keep yourself awake at night. It's not worth worrying about.
Very rarely. If he was doing the Haydn, for instance, which he knows very well, he might go through it. He might. And if he was doing something he didn't know very well, then yes, he would work at it a little bit, but what he calls working at it and what I call working at it are two different things. I mean, he'll probably do a quarter of an hour here and 5 minutes here. And
happy with your wash?
Of course.
What about close-up?
When it's the commercials, he just has a little blow. He leaves the sound of the television, usually. Doesn't take himself very seriously.
Okay, let's choose a low temperature and wash two dirty socks. Now see these shoe polish marks. Look at them close-up and watch that dirt lift out. Aerial Automatic's advanced biological formula removes dirt that ordinary powders leave behind, even without boiling.
It's true. Everything I can't boil is so much cleaner.
Now, as you know, Previn has cancelled all these shell tour concerts, plus a festival hall, due to foot problems. Bless him. Now, I think we've now got a replacement, Occo Camu. You'll find in the file that the hotel's already reserved. And even for Glasgow, I think it's going to be cheaper to train it up.
Should be a total of 32 on
that's the one. You're all here, are you?
Yeah, we're all.
Much obliged. Have a nice trip.
I've done about, 40 years of it now. Could get a bit tedious.
Okay, go on.
Yes.
I'm in a generous mood. Very generous mood here, Sam. Now, dear, you said 40. No, I can't afford to subsidise you anymore.
But we stay off the board, didn't we, the darts?
You have to tell him his address every time we get home.
This is a good crowd, actually, to be with. The orchestra's good social life as well as not being a bad orchestra to boot.
We always think when we come to Glasgow, well, we'll be able to get a good curry. There's a good curry Indian restaurant. And in fact, that's what we always do. We then usually get out of the place as quickly as we can.
It
it's like a well-oiled machine. When you actually do it to her, you've got it all under control. You do lose a lot of the nervous excitement about going away, as you had when you were in your early 20s, but it's a different sort of thing now. It's a lot more gentle. You look after your health a bit more, you don't drink quite as much, and you're in better condition in many ways.
There's something about playing in a symphony orchestra that is important. When it comes to a concert, you always play. Everybody does their best. I mean, that's always been the way an orchestral musician works. And rehearsals may be a bit boring, maybe dull, maybe we slacken off a little bit, but you'll never find a professional symphony orchestra that does not try at its very best, under the conditions, at a concert.
Sometimes there's an internal thing going when all the chemistry is right and the wind's blowing in the right direction, and you can't actually explain what it is, but something happens and you get a great performance.
I've got to make a decision in the mornings whether or not I put in a telephone call to various people, get the hotel to make a call. Actually, it's also quite a good thing to make sure they're actually at the hotel, because they mightn't have come home overnight either.
This young Finnish conductor, Oko Kamu, is not very well known in this country, but he's a very nice guy and a good conductor.
Do you ever have problems with conductors?
We did a performance of one particular symphony, which actually very nearly ground to a halt. I mean, it not because it got out, but simply because the guy just got slower and slower. Every time he got to a point that he felt was important, that he wanted to linger over, he took time, and then he never picked it up again, so it just gradually got slower and slower and slower, and until it was absolutely crawling along. And I mean, it's a fairly long piece anyway. We'd have still been there now if I mean, and it was a question of, you know, just put the scroll in the air and start wagging it around a bit and just gently trying to kick the thing along.
Didn't you get two separate beats going on? Half the orchestra following him and half following you?
Well, no, most of them were following me. But he wasn't. He was in a world of his own, God bless him.
I remember a couple of very elderly, eminent conductors who were actually on the rostrum at recording sessions, and they didn't really know terribly what they were doing because of old age.
Yes.
But the experience of the orchestra was able to get through a session and get through. And as long as their name was actually on the
section,
recording.
In your section, you whispered to each other, "Is he dead yet?"
If a conductor brings you in fractionally early or late, do you just ignore them?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, of course you do. I mean, the number of wrong leads you get, you know, bar early. And if it came the first time, your heart goes, and you think, oh, he's one of those, is he? Thereafter, you know, the shutters go up and you just keep. I mean, but we've had worse than that. I mean, believe you me, really dangerous. It's the ones who don't actually really understand that at certain moments where perhaps somebody who's playing a solo just needs a little bit of time, or there is a tempo, a speed, at which a passage works 1.5% faster and it becomes almost unplayable.
It's not easy, actually.
I couldn't remember to do it again, probably.
That's
good,
one,
actually.
Yeah. Try this one.
Three of us, two in the violins and one cello. Basic rules are often not too many bare arms, bare backs, about too distracting or something like that, I suppose. But something that's pretty and that won't stick out too much in the orchestra, and yet something black.
People sometimes have said to me, well, there must be days when don't you get fed up with it? And the honest answer is no, because always there's going to be some little spark there that will make the performance just a little bit different from any other and give that little something. That's why music is wonderful. That's what it's all about.
You never feel it's just another old concert?
No, you can't really feel that. I mean, something actually might happen, so you've got to actually keep your wits about you. I mean, even if the stand falls in front of down, I mean, something might well happen, or the conductor might have a heart attack on the third bar, so you've got to be prepared for something to happen. Yes, I think it's good. It's got quite a good atmosphere.
With this audience, this is Glasgow's own local people that are coming. It's obviously something of an occasion for them. And you can feel it. It's the same in Manchester, Birmingham. It's a special feeling you get in these places. Maybe there isn't such a tremendous choice of music making as we have in London. You know, there's such a vast amount of music to go at. And there's also, I think, a sense of community, which perhaps you don't get in a London audience. It's not a terribly big hall. And for a band like ours, you've really got to be prepared to just be aware of the fact that it is possible to literally overdo it. And to you, and to you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Dennis. So it must be a trombone player.
A trombone.
Right, we're short of one leader and one conductor.
You can almost tell by the applause. If there's a little bit of electricity in the air and they're waiting for something that they know is going to be a bit special, you can feel that. But you can also tell immediately whether it's just going to be a one for the mortgage.
How lovely to see you. You haven't met my wife, have you, Pat?
No, we could go to Brian's fish and chips.
It's an excellent trumpet player.
Fantastic.
Fantastic. Out of this world, as they say. Yeah. Very enjoyable to work with.
I know why I gave it up.
It's fiendishly difficult. I spent years trying to play it, and I never mastered it.
I'd forgotten you were a trumpeter.
He made it sound so ridiculously easy.
What sort of trumpet was he using? You know about
I think it was a small E flat. I said so. Was my really
and yeah. That must be extremely difficult, playing a single instrument with that sort of orchestra behind you.
Not many people would realize that the brass band movement, in fact, is the initial motivation to those with a latent talent who can come up to orchestral standard.
It's very good orchestra. Yeah.
One sticking one's neck out. It's about the best in London at the moment.
Well, Philharmonia wouldn't agree with you on that.
The conductor was superb. And the way he had absolute control.
You were caught up with his enthusiasm. So I don't think anyone missed the esteemed Andrew Previn in respect to the fact that the conductor that did perform, I would agree entirely.
I felt that the strings were too strong in the Mozart. I like that.
I think you never get bored of playing good music, because every day is different and your lips are different. The atmosphere would be different. Traveling, yes. I'd rather be at home all the time. As a matter of fact, I've got the stage now of life where it'd be a fantastic job if I didn't have to play, you know.
one sticking one's neck out. It's about the best in London at the moment.
Well, Philharmonia wouldn't agree with you on that, I don't think.